new John, my soon-to-be husband. Where do I even begin? These past 10 years have been amazing. Who would have thought that a night in the Fleece on New Year's Eve 2009 would lead to this? I'm so lucky to have you by my side throughout everything life throws at us. You make me feel so loved, supported and cared for every day. And I know you'll always have my back. I'm so grateful that I get to spend the rest of my life with you. My family and friends speak so highly of you, and that tells me everything. We've been through some tough times, and those times prove to me that you really are the one for me. Together we've dealt with loss, upset, cancelled weddings, but we always manage to make each other smile at the end of the day. I know a piece of you is missing today, and I'm honoured to have got to know your dad, and it's clear to me the husband and father you'll be. From your dad's morals, kindness and humour, he'd be so proud of you today, and always will be. Open the black box and keep this close to you today and always. I'm so proud to call you my husband, and you'll make the most amazing father one day. I really couldn't think of a better person to spend my life with. See you at the aisle.
To my wife-to-be, we finally made it. It has been long and overdue, but I finally get to marry you and I can't wait. Thank you for keeping us going and all of the hours of preparation you have put in today. It's going to be the best day of our lives. We have been in each other's lives for so many years now, and you have made my life so much better, and I couldn't imagine it without you. You really are my best friend and whole life, and the fact you will now be my wife is incredible. I'm going to stop.
You're beautiful, dear. Absolutely beautiful. God bless you. Don't use that. It's starting me. God bless you. You look good. You look good. Absolutely.
Are we ready?
We can do this.
You might like to bear in mind that this building is 1,000 years old. Just think of all the couples who have started their married life, like John and Jen are today, in this beautiful building. And what better surroundings for a momentous occasion like a wedding?
Would you please be understanding for the entrance of the bride?
Here we go.
There goes my heart beating, 'cause you are the reason I'm losing sleep. Please come. There goes my mind racing, and you are the reason that I'm still breathing. I'm hopeless now. I climb every mountain, I swim every ocean, just to be with.
Son and Holy Spirit, we have come together to witness the marriage of Jen and John. John Michael, will you take Jennifer Michelle to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Jennifer Michelle, will you take John Michael to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live.
I will.
We're here to celebrate what's brought you to this day. Think back 12.5 years to when you met on a New Year's Eve night out, both queuing to go into a nightclub in Richmond. Did they have nightclubs in Richmond?
They did.
They did, the one and only.
And you were both in the queue, and John must have been in front because he turned around and looked, saw you, Jen, and went, wow!
Oh my gosh, I'm
sorry. Jen, today we're all going, wow! And later that evening, your paths crossed again. I wonder if that was by accident or design. And as Jen put it, the rest is history. So, what is love? Well, as I've shared those memories that you have shared with me, I don't think I've used the word love much, if at all. But you know, I think all that I've said could be summed up with that one four-letter word, love. Jen, I give you this ring.
Jen, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
With my body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
John, I give you this ring.
John, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
With my body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Those whom God has joined together, let no man or woman put asunder. John, would you like to give your wife her first kiss?
I've obviously got to thank everyone who's travelled far and wide to be here today, because some of you have made a real effort, and I just can't believe I'm baffled by the generosity and the effort you've all made, because it's going to be a hell of a day. It's been a long time coming, you know, we've all been itching to get out for the past year and a half, so let's party and party hard. So obviously having both your brothers as best man tells you one of two things. It's either that John's got no mates, which is kind of, or that we are in fact the two best men in our family, which we obviously like to think.
John really, really came into his element at college though. Some phenomenal wet look hairstyles. Some of the lowest cut, tightest t-shirts I've ever seen in my life. And probably my favourite, some incredible Zoolander impressions. Look at the power of that! Phenomenal.
Now on to the main event, and the most important person, not just today, but for the rest of my life, my wife. Everyone knows that Jen is caring, smart, and beautiful. You don't need me to tell you that. But after the past year and a half of this pandemic, her qualities have really shone through. She has kept the show on the road, and instead of giving up, she has persevered through the hard times and made planning a wedding 3 times as enjoyable as it could possibly get. So that takes skills, so thank you for that, Jen. Through laughter and tears, we have finally made it. And Jen, I just want to say thank you, and I could not be luckier to have you beside me. Some of you may know the story of how I met Jen. Actually, some of you in the room were there on that night, New Year's Eve. It basically started with me turning around in the queue to the fleece, shout out to that sweat pit. And I said, wow.
Like that.
I've since said wow on a number of occasions, obviously being with Jen for so many years. but no more so than when I turned around in the Priory today and saw you walking down the aisle. Only one word could do you justice in that moment, and that was well. Wow.